It's Fate Time! Hello and welcome to another Figure Review. Today we're going to have a look at the Figma number 151. It's Emiya Kiritsugu. One of the figures that I've been hunting down for I don't know how long. One of the main protagonists, the main protagonist of Fate Zero and Shiro's adoptive dad. We got Kiritsugu finally. So, I got this one pre-owned. I'm just going to say that real quick. So that's why the box is all kind of busted up. I don't care. I just wanted to finally have the figure. So without further ado, let's have a look at it. Damn, boy, he tall. Let's see how much he stands at about 16 centimeters to the top of his head, which means we are going up to 6.2, almost 6.3 inches size comparisons.
Here's Daughter. SH Figure Arts Krillin. NECA Michelangelo. Unlimited Blade Works Shiro. Iris Wiel von Eisbern, Ilya, if we had one good smile, and Darkseid.
Overlook in detail all the figure, obviously it's not the most riveting design, but what is here is done well, and that's really like one of the old Figmas. We have the quality control actually lining up. So first and foremost, I love the eyes. You have like this dead expression, no detail in the irises. That's how he looks in the show. That's how he looked all throughout it. Got the stubbles on the chin. And then obviously you can tell there's a hole in his mouth. That's for the cigarettes. Yes, he does come with small cigarettes, which I'm not a fan of, that they didn't just directly connect that to the face and not have me fiddle around with it. The hair is nice and fuzzy. If you go around it, there's a bunch of detail in it. Also looks accurate. And as you move down, the rest of it is, it's a suit and a coat. Now it is painted for the most part, I think. Like soft plastic part of the coat is not, but it's soft plastic. So I don't really, there seems to be a little bit more of a shine to the arms because of that than the coat, but that's fine. That's not even an issue. In here, you got some more detail in it. There's obviously no shading whatsoever, but you don't really need it. There's also the plastic over here. It doesn't look too cleanly done. But moving down to the hands, you got the symbol, which I just completely forgot how to call it again. Let me remind me in the comments. I mean, I know what it's called, but it's been a while since I, it's actually been really a while since I had some Fate stuff, Fate related content on the channel, or since I watched anything. As we go down, you have the other parts of the coat, which are just connected via ball hinges, but we'll look at that once we get to the articulation. Got some buttons. The pants, the nice working pants, do have a lot of gaps under them, but you're not really gonna see it. And we move down to the brown shoes. With not much more to say. I mean, there's some wrinkle in the outfit, but overall it does look pretty clean. It does look pretty good. Not much to complain about, so let's move on. For your articulation, the head sculpt is fairly limited. You have some back and forth wiggle motions, obviously blocked because of mostly the hair. Does tilt side to side somewhat, and it does go all the way around, but you do also have neck articulation, so you can combine that. And from what I can tell, I think the neck is just on a ball. But it's still got some fairly good range in there, and it offers some more options. The shoulder articulation, it's Figma. That hasn't changed. You have the ball hinge that ends on another ball, so you can bring it up. It's obviously blocked by the coat a little bit, so it doesn't go much more up than that. You can also rotate it in there, and the entire arm also swivels. Your entire shoulder have the elbow, which is just on a simple hinge. And this is the only thing with, like, how do you spot a classic Figma? By seeing this hinge in the hand. We didn't have ball hinges back then, so it essentially still accomplishes pretty much the same. It just looks a whole lot uglier, but yeah, goes back and forth and swivels. For the entire torso part, there's not really anything they did here. I know with like classic Figmas, usually they have like some kind of joint in the back, but with this one, they were just like, nah. But as you can tell, let's go down in the inner workings of the figure. So you have this upper part, which moves around on the ball, and then it just connects to the classic Y, kind of like Y hinged double ball, triple ball one, which is still connected to the gray part, and just moving that around without moving the gray part is kind of iffy. So I don't know, I guess you get like a double bend on that note, but I mean, it's all right. So you can also obviously rotate it in here, and as far as the legs go, you can rotate them on the ball joints, goes forward, goes out to the side, and legs feel super wobbly, and I feel like they would disconnect all the time, but they don't, so that's cool. As for the coat, you have ball hinges over here, which goes up and down, not the greatest range, but it's alright, and also some swiveling on there, as much as room as you have. and then you have simple ball hinge in the knee. For the foot, it's another ball hinge, so it goes up. It's probably pretty much blocked by the pants, but you do get some stability out of it. And that's it already. And for the accessories, starting off with the faces, which I try to record over and over again, but the camera doesn't want to focus. This, like this? Okay, good. Got the angry face and the somewhat smiling face, like really unsure about everything he does. And then you have these forearm things for the jacket. You just use that if you want to put his hands in his pocket. That's what that's for. Also, there's instructions in the back. We have a gun, which is like the WA-2000, I guess, from what it says in the instructions. It looks nice enough. It's pretty big. It looks somewhat like a sniper, but you know, I'm not a gun expert. And I'm just kind of curious about one thing over here, because you have these two firing effects. Now this one goes over it. Yeah, okay. So you have the firing effects, which are weird, because as I just showed you, they don't usually have fire effects that go into the barrel, but these ones go over the barrel. So, you know, it works, it stays on there and whatnot, but it absorbs part of the gun, so that's just kind of weird. Anyway, here's the other gun, which I don't know what it's called. Does it have a name? It's a gun. So you can also open this like that, which is probably for reloading, because he does have a bullet. He does have a hand with a bullet, spoilers. And then here's a smaller gun, which has a smaller firing effect. The firing effect both looks the same, but it's like the pack hole for that does the difference, obviously. So you just drape that over here, which barely goes on, but you go like pew pew pew. Bleh, bleh. Then you have the Figma base, because every Figma has that, and the instructions, because also every Figma has that, and you have the Figma back. And then for the hands, you got a whole bunch of like fist hands, open hands, well, slightly open, and then one for each side with the trigger finger, and then like really big one. And finally, you got one more hand which has a little hole in there for the cigarette, and the other one which has like a golden bullet, and it's actually connected to the hand. I love it. Oh yeah, and of course I almost forgot to show you the cigarettes, because they're so tiny and I don't want to take them out. And here you go, I'm just gonna give you a look, because if I take them out of the box, I will never be able to fumble around with it because it's so freaking small. But you have some that are smaller, some that are a little bit longer, and the ones on this side are bent on the top. But yeah, also there you have like a little bit of gray, blackish on it. So those are actually on, those are not on, but it doesn't matter. You have four different cigarettes, holy. Final thoughts, and one thing I can say, the cigarette does fit in pretty nicely. It's actually a lot thinner at some part, and it really tells you how to put it in. So it's a specific angle you have to put it in, so you cannot spin it around once it's in there. But at least once it's in there, it's also nice and tightly, which is something I highly appreciate. But back to the figure at hand. As I was saying, it's a simple figure. However, he has an impressive size, which is cool. So he stands out immediately from the rest of your Figma collection and comes with a lot of cool accessories, even if like the gun part effect is a little bit questionable how you connect it. But you know, that's a small, small nitpicky detail that I'm not even really angry about. As such, yeah, I still recommend this one. Of course, if you can still find it at a reasonable price point. No, I do not know where you can find it. I bought mine, as I said at the beginning of the video, pre-owned. It was, I think, on AmiAmi, but you can also try Mandaraka, you can try eBay, you can try whichever you like. But no, I don't know. I don't have a magical place where they still sell this guy in mint in box or whatever. You have to look for it. You have to search for it. So just don't pay too much for it, because like, again, it's a good Figma, but it's not like something that really, really blows my mind right now. It's not something that I feel like completely changed how they build Figmas, but however, it is an important character for the Fate universe, and that's why I wanted to get him, and I'm happy with him. That's gonna do it, guys. As usual, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget, if you enjoyed this review, hit it up with a like and subscribe to the channel so you can stay tuned for more figure reviews, card game stuff, and whatever Kiritsugu wants.